All right, now this program right here, will demonstrate one form of file saving and loading. In fact, I've already got a file that's already created, and I created it by running this program before. But first, let me let me run this, even though these aren't exactly related. This button here still does use what's in these text boxes to generate something related to it, but this is a totally different function. But at any rate, I created this before, and this is what's in this particular text file right now. But if I go click the distance, okay, basically to this list box, it's added this to it here. This is what the raw output is. Okay, so it creates this information that you see here, but it also saves it as a file, so now when I hit load, it's actually loading this version of it. So out of the same file, it's just a text file that it's creating. So let's go ahead and stop the program and take a look at the code. So if I click this button, and if you want to see what this does, I got another one of the previous videos is on it. If I click this button, that's taking us to this, and this basically will save the file. So it's checking those first two text boxes that you saw up there, making sure that they're going to fit into a decimal and an integer type, which is fine. Because again, that's how that other function works. So it, you're supposed to enter an integer in one and a decimal in the other. But then we're creating a local variable, hours. Okay, so we're basically converting this, time traveled variable into an integer for the sake of this program, because I don't want to work with decimals in this part of the. For this routine. But basically, anyway, we're creating that. Just ignore this. This is part of another video. But basically, we're creating a StreamWriter object and making instantiating it into a local object, and then we're setting it equal to a file name here, and this file is going to be located in the if you go over here to open file locations in Explorer, it's going to be in binary or bin and debug, so that's where the text file supposedly is located, distance right here. So see it notepad. So this is how the file is stored. Okay, so basically, just like you saw when I ran that code, when I ran the program, but anyway, we're going through, and now we've opened our text file and set its file path, and so I guess you can enter a whole file path here, but if you do, you might want to enter the @ at the beginning of it, just so you can enter single slashes instead of doubles. For I equals 1 to less than or equal to hours, I post increment. Okay, so hours, basically, is this. Okay, so that's why we needed it in the integers, because it was going to use it down here. And although I could have still used the I could have done this differently, but this is just how I did it. I could have made another variable that we assigned, as an integer to that, so I could use it in my loop, but still use the original time traveled, in our program down here. So it could write a decimal value instead of just an integer, be stuck with an integer value in it. But anyway, it goes and you know, calculates the distance based on the speed, and I'm not going to really explain the logic of the program because it doesn't matter. It's a cheesy program. But anyway, here's where we output our file. So we're going output file dot write line. So we're writing in a line at a time, and this is the line. And I guess it'll do a CRLF carriage return line feed automatically in it as part of the operation. But then I'm also adding it to a list box too. So it's pretty much got the same information printed in our list box up there. And then when we're done cycling through the number of hours, you know, and adding a line for each of those hours, you know, it closes the thing. So anyway, it's just telling you the distance you've traveled, you know, after a certain number of hours have elapsed based on your speed. So again, cheesy. And then we have an exception, so if it fails to open the, in the try block, it fails to create a file or whatever, it'll generate an error message telling you what's going on. So it's as simple as that for the, for the writing of the file. Now, you know, if you push the load button, you know, it comes in and does this. Here. I don't know why our cursor's up there and what happened. At any rate, I add this to our list box, basically this little, you know, kind of header thing there, and put a blank space following it, and then we basically, you know, create a string array here. And again, this is just one way of doing it, and I was following this guy's tutor and adapting it to this program while I was doing it. But then we got file.readAllLines method, you know, and then this is the file we're going to read. So basically it's just reading all the lines of that text file, but it's reading it into a string array. So then we're going line number equals new, you know, all lines dot length. So, you know, we're creating an integer, and again, this is part of his program, but I was like, okay, I'm just kind of fucking with some of his code, because I didn't do exactly the same program. I was applying it to this, because he was, you know, the piece of code I showed you to save the file was a totally different exercise of his than the one that he loaded the file, so he's working with a totally different situation. But I was like, hell, I've already got a file saved. I don't want to go create with a text editor a brand new file just to follow your example. So I decided, you know, to use the one we already got, that distance.txt. So I had to modify his program for it, because his program actually read in integers and stuff like that from the file. This doesn't do that, because there are no, at least no, you know, he just had a file full of nothing but numbers. And ours has numbers and text, and, you know, I didn't feel like trying to figure out how to sort that out. So I just did this, and I just decided to go ahead and create an array, just like he did, of integers. You know, the same length, and then that's what you count here, and, you know, we got a counter, so, and a single sum equals this, could be int for this, but needed conversion practice, so I added this. And for each string value in all lines, you know, so it's going through each element of the collection here, or each element of the array in this case. I'm setting the line number equal to this, sum equals counter, and then I'm adding it to our list box, you know, with this text, you know, including a tab character, and, you know, our line number counter, and then, you know, which I just kind of made this up, so it's putting this in the array. It's multiplying our count variable by 2 just to do something interesting, more interesting with it. And then I'm setting our, incrementing our counter, and then at the end of it I add this, and then put a sum, you know, which is right here, value at the bottom of it, which again is meaningless, but still it does something more interesting. And then we have our catch block. But see, what's interesting about this is we're not actually opening a file object. So this really is just using a basic file method, you know, using the generic file dot real lines. So, but we're not actually creating a file object like we did in the previous one, you know, to actually have access to the file. So this is what's kind of interesting about this. So we're not creating a file object like we did before, You know, we're just reading straight from this function. So the system function is just reading it into a generic string array. So every line of the file is going to be entered into the string, you know, automatically by this courtesy of this function. So anyway, I thought this was kind of interesting, you know, how it works. So, you know, it's a little different than other file, you know, reading functions I've seen, you know, particularly, you know, most notably in C sharp or C++. But again, so that's just interesting how it works, and you know, wanted to show that for the, you know, for future reference. So anyway.